It's been a very long process. It started out with our director, Michael Pinchbeck, doing a couple of research trips on his own. And this was before he'd sort of recruited the whole cast to work on the show. So he went out to Paris to look for where Maurice Ravel wrote Bolero and where it was premiered at the Opera in Paris in 1928. And then he came to Sarajevo as well. And it was in the winter, so it was a bit different to, the weather was a bit different to how it is now. And he came out to here, to Sartre, to see some theatre. He didn't know if anything would be on because of the weather. And Yasenko was outside shoveling snow, and he said, yeah, of course the show's going to be on tonight. And he saw them do 1984 here, and was really impressed by, you know, the production, and sort of got speaking to Benjamin and Yasenko and Emila after that, and recruited them to start telling this story of Bolero, but also its relationship to Sarajevo as a city. Mm-hmm. And it made sense to have people who are from that city to be in the production, so that they can speak autobiographically. Mm-hmm. So rather than people just from the UK coming and telling your story, it's really important that people from Sarajevo are able to tell their own story as well. So the production looks at the history of the music. It starts with Maurice Ravel writing it, and his experience during the First World War, which arguably was one of the inspirations for him writing it, the rhythm of gunfire becoming part of the rhythm of the music. And then him fighting in the war, him writing Bolero afterwards, and then Torvald and Dean, who are from Nottingham, which is where Michael and I are from, dancing to it at the 84 Olympics here in Sarajevo. So we kind of cover that arc, and then what happened post-Olympics with the Bosnian War, and then the guys telling their very real experiences. So our story, if you like, is bookended by those two conflicts and brings it right up to date as well. Yeah, hopefully. I mean, it's very different when we tour it to different places. So here, we're very aware that it'll be memories that we're evoking from audience members who lived through that war. So we've obviously tried to treat it very sensitively, and that's why we wanted Benjamin and Yasenko and Emila to speak about it, because they lived through it as well. But also in compared to perhaps a UK audience, who perhaps know less and did not live through the conflict themselves. So from their point of view, it's quite educational. And for them to hear these real stories can, you know, obviously be quite horrifying for them, because we were only aware of what we got through the media in the 90s when it was coming up on the TV, as opposed to living through it ourselves. So playing it to Bosnian audiences, and particularly Sarajevan audiences, versus playing it back home in Nottingham, mm-hmm. is very different. Yeah.